Today's topic is level control in a thermal power plant. To understand this topic, we have to study the following flow diagram. This is water and steam cycle in a thermal power plant. In this we see that first there is boiler drum. It is having water storage. From boiler drum, the steam is going to the turbine. In the turbine, the steam is getting converted into mechanical work, and low pressure steam is going to the condenser. In the condenser, the steam is getting converted into water, and water is being stored in condenser hot well. From condenser hot well, the condensate extraction pump is there, which is sending the water to deaerator storage tank. And from deaerator storage tank, through the boiler feed pump, we are sending water to the boiler drum. So here the complete cycle is getting over. And this cycle repeats itself again and again, as shown in this diagram. From boiler drum, the water is going to the condenser hot well. From condenser hot well, the water is going to the deaerator. And from deaerator, water is going to the boiler drum. So we are having three tanks. Tank number one, boiler drum. Tank number two, condenser hot well. Tank number three, deaerator storage tank. So in this cycle, it is a closed cycle, the total quantity of water is fixed or constant. So if we are able to maintain water level in these two tanks, in the third tank, because the water quantity is constant, the third tank shall be maintaining its level by itself. So here we see that out of the three tanks, you are required to maintain only two tanks. That means level in two tanks. Suppose you are maintaining boiler drum level and condenser hot well level, then the level in the deaerator storage tank shall be maintained by itself. That means we require only two control valves and two controllers to maintain the level in all three tanks. So here we can see that to maintain the condenser hot well, we are having hot well level control valve, and to maintain boiler drum water level, you are having feed water regulating valve. Now the same thing we shall give you in the notes form. So water and steam cycle in a thermal power plant, we have just now discussed. The same thing is being given to you in written form with the help of the following slides. So you may go through these slides one by one and try to understand the concept. So here is the second part of the theory behind the water and steam cycle, and here is the third slide, and then we are having the fourth slide. And we are telling that the process goes on repeating in a cyclical manner. In this enclosed cycle, there are three water tanks in which water level is to be maintained. If water level is maintained in two tanks, in the third tank, the water level shall be maintained by itself. The total quantity of water in a closed cycle is constant. Hence, if water level is maintained in 2, in the third tank the level shall be maintained by itself. This is the theory in nutshell. So same thing we can see in this diagram. So the important conclusion is that for the three tanks shown, under the steady state conditions the tank level is required to be maintained in only 2. So we require only 2 control valves and associated with them 2 controllers. So same thing we can see here, for the three tanks we are having 2 control valves and we are maintaining level in, out of the three tanks we are maintaining level in 2 tanks. So the question first, out of the three tanks we are going to choose which 2 tanks for maintaining the level or regulating the level. So here we choose the boiler drum level because it is the most critical. Why boiler drum level maintenance is too critical? Because if water level is low, the water tubes in the steam generator may get damaged because of the low water level. And if the water level is high, the steam tubes shall get damaged because of the deposition of salts inside the steam tubes. And if the water level is too high, steam along with the steam water may go to the turbine and turbine may get damaged. So we can see that to maintain the water level in the boiler drum is most critical. So we have to maintain boiler drum level. Now the next question, of the remaining 2 tanks, which one shall be regulated? So for this the answer is, out of the other 2 tanks we shall maintain the one in which the area of cross section is less. So from our experience we see that in the bigger thermal power stations the area of cross section of the condenser hot well is much smaller than that of area of cross section of derator tanks. So as per the criterion mentioned, and the criterion is area of cross section, it is advisable to regulate condenser hot well, that is tank number 2, with the help of hot well level control valve as shown in the diagram. So to maintain this condenser hot well level, we are having the hot well level control valve. The question 3 is, what is the basis of area of cross section criteria? The answer is, the criteria is rate of rise of level in a tank is proposed proportional to 1/A. That means rate of rise of level in a tank is inversely proportional to area of cross section. How we have arrived at this criteria, this relationship? So the relationship has been developed with the help of this diagram. So we are giving various terms, and after this we are giving you the derivation. So you have to go through this diagram, and then you have to go through the derivation. It is very simple derivation, and from this derivation we come to arrived at this relationship. That means rate of rise of level in tank is inversely proportional to area of cross section. So from this we arrived at the conclusion that to maintain the tank level we have to use a control valve. This control valve is regulated by a level controller. Here we have given a typical level controller scheme. So you are having this level transmitter. There the output of level transmitter is going to the PID controller, and output of the PID controller is going to the control valve. This is the typical scheme. So that you can note down the derivation, I will again repeat these slides very slowly so that you can note down the derivation. Conclusion. While designing a tank level control loop, the area of cross section of the tank should be kept in mind. The salient features of this lecture series. This lecture series is a combination of diagrams, notes and lectures. When one clicks the play button, the lecture starts. When one clicks the pause button, the main points of the presentation can be noted down. Usefulness of this lecture. This lecture is useful for control and instrumentation engineers, operation engineers of the thermal power plant, and the process design engineers. This is myself who has delivered the lecture. This is my email address where you can send your suggestions and comments. And finally, thank you.